Thank you, John, and to my faculty colleagues, I cannot tell you what a pleasure it is to stand up here as a professor of physics, material science and engineering, and Henry, I apologize, but very recently, because of the kindness of Henry and his colleagues, I've now added public policy to that list, and so I'm delighted to join your faculty, Henry, and thank you so much. I'm going to be extremely brief here. Mainly I'm going to introduce Mary Sue Coleman. I think we had a meeting here a year ago, which was the beginning of the first time that we announced publicly that the Lincoln Project would actually happen. It's now fully launched, and we've now had a couple of meetings, one actually the entire afternoon for a subgroup of the members of the Lincoln Committee. It's both very exciting, but it's simultaneously very challenging. And you'll, I think many of you know the challenges that public higher education faces in this country, in the state of California, and the country generally. But I think we've successfully brought together some of the most innovative minds in the country to try and figure out solutions, long-term solutions, to stabilizing public universities and ensuring that they maintain their public character. We're going to hear from three of the participants in the Lincoln Project, one actually as our overseer, Don Randall, and two members of the committee. And I'm going to hand it over to Mary Sue Coleman, who's been, I think everybody knows, an extraordinary leader in public higher education here in the United States. I won't go through all of the institutions she's led, but most recently, for 11 years now, correct,
Mary Sue? 12 years.
12 years. See how
who's counting, flies? Though, right?
Who's counting? has led with extraordinary skill the University of Michigan, one of our great partner institutions in public higher education. She's indeed about to transition out of that role into private life, and so we're really privileged to have her here on our campus. I'm sure this won't be the last time, I know it's a fact, it won't be the last time you will visit this campus as the Lincoln Project progresses, but it's really a privilege to have Mary Sue here, who's been a great colleague as a fellow university leader and as her and her husband as personal friends of Mary Catherine and mine over certainly our entire time in leadership positions in higher education. And we'll continue as partners and as faculty members. So Mary Sue.